Yesterday, Geoffrey Onen, the head of DNA at the Government Analytical Laboratory in Wandegeya, testified as the 18th prosecution witness, and he presented the DNA analysis reports of a number of samples picked from the deceased, the suspects, and the scene of crime, among other places.
The first exhibit, my lord, was number 8.
Onen told court that they took blood samples from all the suspects, analyzed Kitaimbwa's t-shirts, pants, and underwear, toothbrush got from Kasolo's home, panga got from the roof of Johnson Lubega's home, Najirinya's artificial hair, nail clipper, a bottle of water found in the car, swabs of a vehicle steering wheel, and a pack of juice which was also found in the vehicle. He further revealed that most of the items got from the suspects matched the DNA of the samples picked from the scene of crime.
We prepare reports based on the outcome of our analysis.
As the hearing resumed today, prosecution asked that this evidence be tendered in court. However, Kopriam Kasolo, the prime suspect, greatly protested the move. He demanded that the state produces the officers who collected these samples such that he can confirm their authenticity. Kasolo's protest was supported by defense lawyer Julius Serwambala. This led to a heated argument between prosecutors and the defense team, with prosecution insisting on having the evidence tendered, while Kasolo and Serwambala rejected the move.
Right for him to rejoin after I have rejoined. That is not the procedure of practice in law.
And in the interest of justice, my lord, we just take a minute to address you, because Mr. Kasolo wrote it up and it is very important.
Nonetheless, court proceeded with the hearing. The 19th prosecution witness, Superintendent of Police Nixon Ogwang, the head of camera department, presented CCTV footage captured by cameras on the road. In his testimony, Ogwang explained how the accused persons planned and executed the kidnap and murder of Najirinya and Chitaimbwa. As expected, Kasolo protested this evidence.
Behind it, the camera did not show what was behind that camera, behind it.
Presiding Judge Isaac Muwata adjourned the matter to the 29th of March, the 3rd, 4th, and 6th of April. However, Kasolo said he will not be available on the 6th since he is a pastor in the prison, and on that day he will be preaching to fellow inmates.
He was here yesterday, he's here today, and yet he, after admission or not of these exhibits, we have to continue with him up to the very end of his cross-examination.
The five suspects are charged with double kidnap, double aggravated robbery, and double murder of Maria Najirinya and Ronald Kitaimbwa, which happened in August 2019. Still in court, an American couple has been committed to the High Court for trial on five counts of aggravated trafficking and torture of 10-year-old foster son. Nicholas Spencer and Mackenzie Lane Mathias Kenza were today appearing before Buganda Road Court Magistrate Sarah Tusime, who committed them to the International Crimes Division of the High Court. Prosecution alleges that the couple between December 2020 and December 2021 at Naguru in Kampala recruited, transported, and maintained a 10-year-old by means of position of vulnerability for purposes of exploitation.
The accused person stayed in Jinja District with the children, including the victim, until February 2020 when they moved to Kampala and lived at their residence in Naguru Hill.
It is further alleged that the couple also committed an act of aggravated torture, contrary to the Prevention and Prohibition of Torture Act of 2012 against a minor, where punishment upon conviction is life imprisonment. Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.